Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to print both even and odd numbers by using while loop in Java. So let's get started. So first we'll be getting the number n from the user, so till which we'll be printing the odd and even numbers. So it's going to be scanner class, so we need to just import that. Import java.util.scanner, and inside our main function scanner input equal to new scanner, and it's going to be system dot in, and in the next line we'll be having our integer n, till which we'll be printing the odd and even numbers. So it's going to be int n equal to input dot next int. So have your next int. If you go with next line, it will be of type string, but n is of type int. Okay, and I will also have a print statement over here. So it's going to be system dot out dot print. I'll just have enter n. So now I will just have a while loop. So it's going to be while, and for printing the odd or even numbers, we will be having a temporary variable. So let me just have the temporary variable, int I be the temporary variable, and first let me show you how to print the even numbers, and next I will show you how to print the odd numbers. Okay, so for printing the even numbers, you need to have this variable I as 2. Okay, so you need to just have this variable initial value as 2, because even the 2 is the first even number, 0 is a neutral number, 1 is an odd number, 2 is the first even number, so you need to initialize that value I to 2 in case if you are printing even numbers. And the condition is going to be I less than or equal to n. So this while loop basically will fail or terminate if our temporary value I is greater than our input value n. Okay, and inside this while loop, what we will do is we will be just printing I. Okay, and we need to do a final thing, which is incrementing the value of I. So in the next line, we will just go here and do I equal to I plus 2. So since we are printing even numbers, we need to have I equal to I plus 2. So now let me explain you how this is going to work. Okay, I'll just have a demo number. So let us take the input number n. Okay, let us have an input number n to be 10. Okay, n is equal to 10. So it comes here, while loop. The condition is going to be I less than or equal to n. So I value is currently 2, 2 is obviously less than 10. So this condition is true. It goes inside the while loop and consider this as an output. So I gets printed. So 2 gets printed over here. And in the next line, we are incrementing the value of I. So it comes here, I equal to I plus 2. I value earlier is 2. So it's going to be 2 plus 2, which is equal to 4. So at the end of this while loop, I value becomes 4. So it again goes here, this time I value is 4, and 4 less than or equal to n, which is 10, condition is true. It goes here, 4 gets printed along with 2, it comes here, I equal to I plus 2, I becomes 6, goes here, 6 less than or equal to 10, condition is again true, 6 gets printed, and 2 gets added to 8 goes here, 8 is less than or equal to 10, true, 8 gets printed, 8 plus 2 is 10. I value becomes 10. 10 is equal to 10, so this condition becomes true. It goes here, 10 gets printed, and I equal to I plus 2, it becomes 10 plus 2, which is 12. So it comes here, 12, and now this condition fails because 12 less than or equal to n, which is 10, is false. So this condition is false, and we'll be having this in the output. That's it. This is the code basically. This is how it works. And for converting this code to an odd number, it's so simple. It's just, you know, two changes, two minor changes, that's it. So if I run it, yeah, enter n, let me go with 20. So here you can see 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, and 20. So I'm getting the even numbers. So now let's go with the odd numbers. So for changing the exact same code to odd number, what you can do is, you need to just change your initial value, that's it. So as I told you, even number starts from 2, right? But odd number starts from 1. because 1 is the smallest odd number. So if I just change this initial value to 1, okay, if I just change this initial value to 1, that's it. So if I just now save it, I'll just explain you how this is going to work. So let me just have the same n equal to 10, okay, our n value is 10, and now I'll just have a small number. 10 is too large. I'll just have it as 6. Yeah, 6 is fine. Yeah, and I'll just have I value over here. So initially when it comes here, I value is 1, so it's 1, and this condition is true. 1 is less than 6, everything is true. It goes here, 1 gets printed, and here is the twist, okay? I equal to I plus 2, I value is 1, so I equal to 1 plus 2, which is going to be 3. So the logic is that if we add 2 to an even number, that number will still remain as an even number. So this example, 4 plus 2 is 6, 6 plus 2 is 8. So even number when added with 2 will surely be again an even number. And exact same case with odd numbers also. If we add 2 with the odd number, that will still remain the same odd number, but it will also be the next odd number to that number. So for example, I am having 3, the next odd number to 3 is 5. So if we add 2, we will be getting that. The next odd number to 5 is 7. If I add with the 2, I will be getting that. So this is the condition over here. Any odd number, if we add with 2, will be an odd number for sure. So we are using that condition. So I value becomes 3 now. It goes here, 3 less than 6, fine, 3 gets printed, I equal to 3 plus 2, 5, it goes here, 5 now, and 5 is less than 6, fine, 5 gets printed, it becomes 7, condition is false now, and this terminates, we will be getting the odd numbers below 6. That's it, just one line of code, okay? And at the end, I will also show you how you can print both the even and odd numbers at the same time. So let me just now run it. I will go with 10. So I'm getting 1, 3, 5, 7, and 9. Okay, so this is it. And in case if you want to have both even and odd numbers, you can just have this while loop twice. Copy this thing and I'll just paste it. I'll just have j equal to 2. And let me just copy the exact same thing. I will just paste here. Rather than I will have j here to j here too, and let me just copy this and paste it. This is going to be odd. Copy this, paste it, even. That's it. So I'm just having a separate variable for both the things, because as I told you, only the initial value is going to change the game, right? So I'm having I is equal to 1 for odd numbers, and this is the odd number while loop, and j equal to 2, which is for the even number while loop, and I'm just changing here also. And you need to also change the print, okay? I didn't change the print, yeah? So this while loop should always have j inside it, and this while loop should always have I, this variable inside it. So make sure that you are changing it everywhere. If you don't change in a spot, you'll be getting some errors. So not errors, you'll be getting wrong value in the output, okay? So let me just now go with 10. So here you can see, we are getting both the odd numbers printed and the even numbers printed for 10. So this is the code, guys, and I hope you would have found this video useful. Do check the playlist of my channel. I've done a lot of programming tutorials in Java as well as C, C++, Python, Node.js, React.js, MongoDB, MySQL queries. Check them out. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.